Came through here, devil. Oh, that one stayed open. Oh shit, there's an order. All right. So this is first. Devil came through here. That's my guess. Stairs lead down.
Come in, come in. There's no need to be afraid. I don't buy it. Come in already. I might need your help with something.
Stephen King novels. I bet it's fancy. Reminds me of beds they have in cheesy country hotels. Like the hotel that this place is. Someone's bled on this chair. Her bloody handprints all over the wardrobe. All right, cool. What's up, Joe?
You need my help. I thought you wanted to kill me.
Why would I want to kill you? You must be mistaken. Who do you think I am?
Joe.
Sorry, I must have gotten the wrong idea.
It happens to me sometimes. I've been known to be a bit intimidating, I guess. But I'm not a violent
person. Or five.
Okay, good to know.
I mean, I will use violence if I'm pushed against the wall. Do you know what I mean?
All too well, Mr. Davis. All too well.
Is this guy also trying to kill people?
Where are we?
I really can't remember the name of this town, but I'm pretty sure the hotel is called Quiet Haven.
This is a hotel.
Oh, Quiet Haven.
I know. It's a joke. They shouldn't charge half the price for this dump, if you ask me.
This is all just a dream, right?
It's funny that you would say that. I've already heard that somewhere today. But if this is a dream, I've been asleep for a very long time.
I'm sorry. I just want to leave.
Yes, I understand. I wouldn't stay here myself if it was my decision to make. I'm stuck here too. You see, my wife Ivy is in the room to the left. She's a little fragile at the moment. She said she was going to do her makeup, but it's been a week now.
Oh God.
Maybe longer. Every time I try to talk to her, she just gets angry, and she tells me she's not done yet. I've cooked her a meal, but she ignores me. She never likes what I cook.
But what's that got to do with me?
If you talk to her, I'll show you the way out. I promise. Just go in there and tell her she looks fine. She's always so careful about looking perfect.
Okay, I'll see what
I'm sure she looks completely normal.
So, your wife's been in that room for a week?
Now that you bring this up, I think it might have been a month.
That's a lot of time to put on makeup.
That's a very long time to stay in one place.
She wants to look great. I guess it takes time, but we really have to go now. I think there's a big storm coming. I feel it in my bones.
Right.
Goodbye, Joe.
Okay. Metal cover is tightly screwed in place. I can't remove it by hand. Wardrobe examined. There's nothing special about it. Joe's wife, poor woman.
Hello? Misery. Is that what you said? Hello? Misery. Is that what you said?
Misery!
Yeah, she looks good. I told her she looks good. What?
So, your wife's been in that room for a week?
Now that you bring this up...
That's a very...
She wants...
Alright.
I think that... I feel...
Alright, hold on. Can I go back up here? I can't. Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Nothing new I can inspect, is there? Got a bed. Got a Joe. Got a chair. Got a wardrobe. Got an extension cord. Power lead. A lot of mirrors. We don't have anything else? Wear a black dress? Hang back. Oh. Nope. There was no other option for this, was there? The third option there. Misery. Wait, misery. I don't know. I can't do anything with this, right? Bloody prints all over it. Bookcase. Oh, wait, I didn't search the bookcase before? There's a book titled Misery. Oh, it's probably an updated option. Is that what you meant? It's a long shot, but I might as well try. Okay. Now we got a book called Misery. Stephen King, Misery. I had not read that one before. Let's see here. Oh. Screwdriver. I suppose a part of me expected a gun. This will come in handy for sure. Oh. Okay. Pull left switch, pull right switch. Let me save here. We haven't saved in quite some time. And saving would be prudent. Left switch! Wait, what the fuck? Mirror turned off? Soul Reaper! Thank you for 3 months of sub hype. What the fuck? What are the states that we've got here? We've got tilted down like that. This has 3 states. Wait. What, where's that other state? Hold on. That one. But we did that and then right already. So let's... Oh, never mind. This is doing different than I think. That's tilted farther down. Nope. Get the super tilted down version. Welcome to twitch.tv, where things...
Squawk here, also hi Lobos.
Thanks, Dominique. Good timing. Spooky, it says. Also hi Lobos. Thank you, Dominique. Goodbye. 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 Alright, is there any clue? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Right, right. Right, right. No, wait. Right, right, left, right, right. Okay. Right, right, left, right, right. Right, right, left, right, right. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
No. 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 No! This isn't Ivy. This isn't my wife. It's the monster. It followed me here. It always follows me. No matter what I do.
Look, I'm sorry.
You must kill it.
What? Why me?
You still got that power lead, haven't you? The one you stole from me?
How do you even know about it?
You must use it to kill her. To strangle her.
You're out of your mind.
Do it. Strangle the goddamn creature so it never follows me again, or I'll shoot you right here, right now.
Kill me if you want, but I won't do that.
You're with her? I should have guessed.
Uh-oh.
I can't trust you.
Uh-oh.
You're better off dead.
Well, good thing I'm immune. I'm immortal.
Are you alright, Mrs. A? You look like you've seen a ghost.
I didn't do it.
Something strange happened. Maybe I am mad after all.
Don't be silly. I was gone for less than 1 minute.
Really? Somehow it felt longer than that.
A little longer.
Time drags when you've got nothing to do, I guess. I see you found the laptop cable. That's good news, because I don't think mine will be any good. Let's see what's on this hard drive, shall we? That was a waste of time.
Never mind. At least now we're sure it's not him. Let's just go. I don't want to spend another minute in this place.
Oh, I got a screwdriver for the freaking
paint. Did you think of a vegetable?
Paint.
What?
I'd asked you to think of
what
a vegetable.
What was the vegetable I chose?
I chose the... So? Did you?
Yeah. Sure.
Great.
Oh, it was broccoli.
So don't tell me. Was it... carrot?
No.
No.
Broccoli.
Sorry.
Oh, that's odd. Are you sure?
Yes. I thought about
Sally. What? No, broccoli!
Let's go. Joe can come back any minute, and you don't want to meet him. He is not a nice guy.
Whatever. Whatever. Pizza is a vegetable, that's true. Okay. Why haven't we crossed off our own flat yet? Anyways, let's go, you know what? I bet you the guy doesn't live in any of the flats, and he's behind that wall that the dress is near. In any case, let's continue working on the dress here. Back. Screwdriver on this. Yep. Okay. Take it. Wait, but.
Okay, So what do we need?
Well, basically, we need three things.
Got it.
Red paint. We've got it already. The dress will make a great costume. We just need it in black.
It's already in black.
Also, it
needs
look
to be mutilated.
Damaged. That's important. Cat Widow is a ghost after all. I'll need some scissors for that.
Hi, Qualaza.
We need some kind of mask. I don't want him to recognize me.
Okay. Perhaps the power cable thing can help with the power thing upstairs? I don't know. Nope. Okay. We can do this again. We can get this guy to come out here. Time-based, or I have to actually move left? Oh, it is time-based.
Damn fuse. Just keeps tripping. It's like we're living in the Stone Age here.
Jesse, can we talk to you, please?
Later, mate. Later. I'm really, really busy right now.
A little spooky, easy. I'm planning a prank? Something like that, yeah.
This fuse and me, we're playing a dangerous game. It seems I am losing, but I'm a patient guy.
Jesse, can we have a quick word?
Sure, but not right now. I'm right in the middle of something.
I mean, he had unique dialogue, so we're gonna keep doing this.
This fuse and me, we're playing
fuck.
A date, it seems.
Jesse.
Sure.
Suppose there's... Wait, the stairs go up? Looking at... Oops, what did she say? It's painful. Bad idea, I think she's home. Well? That was Brian's place. And this was... Oh, the old man. I guess we're done with him now, so... Second floor is Crazy Dude in our own flat. Can't go into his place anymore. Something with this fuse box that I can take? No? Alright, go ahead on the first floor then. Hey, Nolan Craig, how's it going? Hello, Wire Wolf. Whoa. There's nothing to do here. Right. Go back in here. Outlet socket. Nope. Interesting. Why is there a cougar or a lion? Okay. I can't check the dog lady's room. Then we'll go to the ground floor. Wait. That wasn't the second floor. Hold on. Oh, no. Ground floor is not the first. Mailbox!
Hey, Lubes.
I know you're always in search of good rouge-like games, so have you seen Sub-Level Zero? If not, check it out. It's a first-person in the cockpit 3D shooter.
I like rouge-likes. Thank you for the donation, Coca. Send me that game in a message, and I will check into it. Oh, okay, good. Rouge-likes. Is there something I can do here now? Pipes, coal chute.
Okay. We need.
What the fuck?
So.
Oh, here we go.
What next?
Maybe we can find some clues in the mail. There's a mailbox in the hall.
I checked that. I didn't check it recently, but. Okay. Skipping. Well, we've seen that dialogue several times at this point. Communal mailbox holds all tenants' mail in separately locked compartments. Oh! She can fucking pick locks.
Do you think you can unlock this mailbox?
I think I can most certainly unlock this mailbox.
Then do it quickly. Someone can come in any minute.
Don't fall for the mailbox jump scare again. The bar.
A little room for the master locksmith.
Really?
Could you step away towards the stairs and turn around?
What is she doing? Oh, fine. I'll actually move myself. That's
master criminal, if anything.
Cross his arms.
Done. Here's all the mail. Hide it in your pockets and let's get out of here. It was mostly junk mail and leaflets. I threw those away.
Okay. Letter to Pauline. Letter to Joe. Who's Pauline? Hey, oh, the mother. Oh, okay. Not here. She'll be back any minute. And we'll be caught red-handed. Okay. Let's go downstairs, I guess.
Well, well. Looks like Pauline is looking for a babysitter. This letter says she's supposed to interview an agency nanny later today.
Great. I could be a nanny.
It's certainly worth a try, but I should warn you. I don't want to have anything to do with that baby.
All right.
You're gonna have to handle this on your own.
Sure, I understand. Leave it to me, Mrs. A.
From Dr. Frank Zellman. It appears he's Joe's shrink. Apparently Joe failed to attend his weekly sessions recently. Well, well. Looks like Joe's just as messed up as I am. Or worse. Who knows? I should be the last to make judgments, really. Okay. All right. Time for nanny business.
Right.
Bombing.
Step back. I'll handle this.
Step back.
Oh. Hello?
Hi.
Door.
I've heard you're looking for a babysitter. Is that correct?
Well, yes, that's correct.
Look no further. My name is Mitzi Hunt. I'm currently a student, but I'm great with children. And I could really use a job. These school tuitions get pretty expensive these days.
Okay, maybe. But why is Mrs. Ashworth here? Hello, Mrs. Ashworth.
Hi, Pauline. How are you?
I'm great, thanks. I haven't seen you for ages. Are you here to apply for a job as well?
No, of course not. I...
Come on, Mitzi. Save it! Oh, wait, I'm talking for her. Okay.
Oh, I'm Mrs. Ashworth's lodger. She kindly offered me a room and we've been living together for the last couple of weeks. I mentioned to her
the
I
truth.
Was looking for a job. My parents pay for the room and school fees, but I could do with some extra spending money. So, anyway, I'm starting this course on child psychology next semester, and I thought it would be useful to get some hands-on experience with little children. My mother always says you have to get your hands dirty to learn something properly. Not that you get dirty hands looking after babies. Just metaphorically speaking.
Well, it can get dirty. I hope you understand the job would involve changing nappies too.
Yes, of course. I don't have a problem with that.
Yes.
Nappies.
Well, you sure sound enthusiastic. Would you like to come in? Both of you?
It's okay. I'll wait.
I could really do with your support. You know how shy I get sometimes.
There he goes, thank you for the resub!
Yes. Well, you'll... Okay. You owe me.
We need to work together on this. I'll do the
so
talking,
afraid
I
of babies.
Fine. Just don't do it.
It's too late for that, Mrs. A.
I pay for Lobot sub, actually. Believe it or not.
What a nice flat! I love the wallpaper. Very retro.
Thanks. I decorated myself just before Alyssa was born. Please follow me. We can talk in the living room.
I'll need you to drag her away.
How the hell am I supposed to do that?
I don't know. I'm sure you can think of something.
Why don't you think of something? I told you I don't do babies. I feel so uncomfortable here. I'd gladly blend with this cheesy wallpaper that you like so much and disappear.
I know. So do I. Do you think I know anything about babies? No. But I'm trying to fake it, and so far she's buying it. Look, I need you to stay cool and come up with something that'll make her leave the room. Got it?
But that's where the problem is. I can't think of anything.
Just play it by ear, yeah?
All right, pictures. Mostly photos of a baby, a couple of Pauline and her ex. His face missing on each one of them. She wants to cut this guy out of her life so badly. Why don't she just take these pictures down? Hello.
I should let you know from the start that looking after a toddler is not an easy task. They're just beginning to crawl, they're very curious, and sometimes they can cry for no apparent reason. And my Alyssa, well, she is a very noisy child. Do you have any previous experience with children?
She just has, like, the slightest of an accent. Sometimes she sounds just full-on American, but then, bloop, little bit of Irish or something in there.
Yes, I used to babysit my neighbor's kids.
Excellent. I know we all have to start somewhere, but it helps if you at least know the basics. I'd like to get back to work soon, you see. Just part-time for now. That's why I need someone to stay. I'm not going to find it easy to be apart from Alyssa, but my career has
What's
always
up,
been
Lane?
Important to me as well. They won't wait for me forever. If I don't
Yanni.
Do this now, they'll just replace me.
There just isn't enough support for working parents.
Tell me about it. If I don't get back to work in 2 weeks' time, they will cut my maternity pay in half. So I haven't really got a choice. It's either this, or Alyssa and me will face the life in poverty.
Where do you work?
I'm a hotel manager. It's a very competitive industry, but I've always loved it. I miss it a lot.
I have a great connection with kids. I'm sure I can manage with Alyssa.
Okay, I don't doubt that. How about, would you like to hold Alyssa for a minute? We should probably see if she likes you first.
Yes, definitely. But I ought to wash my hands first.
Your hands?
My hands. I must have touched a million things on my way here. As much as I want to hold her, I just don't think it's safe, you know?
Really? What have you been touching?
Oh, you know, just ordinary things, this and that.
You look pretty clean. I'm sure it'll be okay.
Well, if you must know, I
stroked a filthy looking dog. What's up, Unleashed Fighter? How's it going? That sounds honorable.
Earlier today.
Oh, I'm impressed. You don't see many young people.
There you go, see? Impressor.
But you're right. As nice as that is of you, there's all sorts of bugs you can pick up in a hospital. It won't hurt to be extra careful. I'll show you to the bathroom. Would you mind answering the door for me?
Sure. No problem.
It's probably just my friend Kate. Just
Kate!
Let her in, please. Is that okay? The bathroom's this way. Follow me.
Let me guess. It's Joe. And we're dead.
Your turn, Mrs. A.
Seriously?
Do something. Anything.
Fine. Make sure you scrub those dirty hands really well. I need a bit of time.
Ernie, examine those. Before we go answer the door, let's see. TV. That's a big TV. Ah. Something Missy is telling her some fake stories about her childhood. Oh, shit. What is that? Maybe I can quickly check that room later if she eventually starts washing her hands. Okay. Books. And a few toys. Sparkling clean. Most of these photos show Pauline and her kid. There's also some guy on a few of them missing to be cut out.
Hello?
Hello?
Kate?
Are you Kate?
I've been sent by the agency.
Uh-oh.
My name is Rita Tickle. May I come in,
Rita
please?
Tickle?
Agency? What agency?
The Happy Nanny Babysitters Agency, of course.
No.
We bring fun and professionalism into
I don't want a babysitter.
At a discount price.
No.
May I come in, please?
Wait,
just hang on a second.
I believe we have an appointment. It was confirmed by post.
Post!
Did you get a letter?
Hang on, I said.
Beat it, Four Eyes.
The position has already been taken.
Oh, great. Are you sure?
Yes, I'm sure. Thanks for your time. See ya.
Wait. There must have been some kind of mix-up.
No, there wasn't a mix-up.
She like eating a brownie when she said that?
I'd better call the office and find out what happened.
Good. Wait. Beat the shit out of her, how about that? Wait, I can just leave? I don't... God. Bitch.
This fuse and me, it's...
Yeah. I did it. Let's... TV, please. I don't know enough about computers. That's a baby. What? Scissors? I'll take those. Fucking putting scissors on the bed. Yeah, there you go. Leaving baby right next to a pair of sharp scissors. Gob, idiot. Photos. Lots of photos of Pauline and her ex. Okay. Need the water running. I must hurry. They could be out any second now. What am I supposed to be doing? I need to go cut the power? Is that what I need to do? Oh, never mind. I just needed to leave the
So,
room.
Was it my friend at the door?
No, just some door-to-door salesman.
Well, I hope you told him to go to hell. I honestly don't know what these people are thinking.
Yeah, me neither.
Oh. I'm sure it's Kate this time. I'll let her in if you'll excuse me for a minute.
Wait! I think I forgot to turn the tap off in the bathroom.
Oh, that's okay, don't worry. Would you mind going back to the bathroom and turning it off while I answer the door?
I think I've got something in my eye.
Right.
I can't touch my eye. I'll need some help to get it out.
You'll be fine. Just go back to the bathroom and use one of my cotton buds. Don't be such a baby, Mitzi.
I'm feeling really sick all of a sudden.
Oh. Do you think you're actually going to throw up?
Yes, definitely. Oh, yes.
Quickly, go back to the bathroom. I don't mean to be rude, but this is a very expensive carpet.
Will you come with me?
Carpet.
Please, what if I faint? I'm scared. Everything's just spinning around.
Can Mrs. Ashworth go with you for a change?
It's okay. I'll answer the door and let your friend in, yeah?
Well... Fine. I'll put Alyssa in her bed for a minute and I'll come with you. You must have got some bag in the hospital after all.
Hi, Kate! Oh, god damn it! I knew it.
It's you! Again!
Hello. Is this flat number 8? My name is Rita Tickle, from the Happy Nanny Agency. May I come in, please?
Nope.
I've told you already. You're too late.
Hello!
You have? I thought I got the wrong door last time.
It's the right door. I was looking for a nanny, but I'm not anymore.
Dude,
do
kill.
You understand what I'm saying?
Yeah. You were looking for a nanny. I have 10 years experience and training in child discipline techniques and behavioral psychology. Also, I am known for good personal hygiene, strong work ethics, and I only take one break every 5 hours. Just to use the restroom.
Wow, that sounds really great. But I'd like you to go away now.
You don't need a nanny.
Nope. I've decided to give my baby up for adoption.
What?
You're an evil person. You'll go to hell for doing that to your baby.
Bye, bae. Wow.
Yeah.
Putting the baby
I've
up for adoption.
I've already been to hell. They don't want me there.
Burp! Burp, 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 burp. Okay. Hi, TV. Don't turn on magically and do terrifying things. Anything else? Or maybe they want me to, go cut the power this time? Yeah. I'll be back. Okay, good, I can go outside. This seems like a bad idea, though. Cutting these with scissors, but... Must be a safer way. I don't know. Whatever. Maybe I'll just cut this dude when he... Cut Jesse when he comes out.
This fuse and me, it's...
Jesse.
Sure, sure.
Alright, Jesse, you turd. I just put blood, like red paint on this pram. Can't cut anything here. Window. Can I cut the TV? Can I cut the baby? Cut the nanny. Why can't I deal... I can't interact with the baby. I don't know anything about computers.
I don't know much about computers.
I couldn't go downstairs, could I? No. Scissors on the electric meter?
Hey kid, I'm a computer. Stop all the downloading.
I don't know about much about computers. My mom got one. I just saw a couple games on it and I just fucking up. I'm missing something. I have an extension cord. Letter to Joe. Nope. Cut up the photos? I'm not looking at chat to avoid spoilers, sorry. I interacted with the window, right? Axe of Fury! Axe of Fury, thank you for the sub. Welcome to the Wolfpack. I'm gonna use the scissors on everything. Thanks for the sub, Axe of Fury. Bookcase. What am I supposed to do? Create a distraction? Our kitchen looks sparkling clean. Can I smear paint all over it? Can I just man up and actually cut them? It'll probably take more than this pair of scissors to cut that man out of her life. Jeff? Listen, I don't think we listened to him before. Fucking. Can't just barge in, can't you though? Shit, is this where I have to, wait. Let's follow where those cables are going, or not. They'd stopped. Expected to hear porn. Shit, I don't know what this trigger is. Bathroom door, photos, laptop. Maybe we cut the laptop. Cut the baby! Smear blood on the photos. Can't knock on the door. Can't open the window. Can't cut the TV, right? Can't Can't do anything with red paint. Just examine it. We read the letter to Joe. We've got the extension cord. We tried using the extension cord on the... on the weird, like, power supply thing. Ram. Looks old, but it seems okay, and it's really long, too. I'm sure I'll find some use for it. Why is she writing on it? Now that the light's off.
This fuse and me, it seems...
Jesse, can...
Sure, but...
I'm missing something. Chat's making me die with laughter. Cut the cheese. Okay, I will accept a hint. I will accept a hint right now. Because it might just be one of those puzzles that's entirely unintuitive. But it also might just be something really easy that I'm missing too. Tiny hint. I will let my mods use their judgment to determine what a tiny hint is. And I'm gonna wait a second so that answers aren't just blatantly thrown in there. What the hint? Switch the power off. Oh, I was totally fucking close just now. Yeah, that makes sense. Cut the cable while the power's off.
These scissors seem sharp enough.
Alright.
Let's create some diversion.
Yeah, power off plus scissors. Had in mind. I think that's a bit more of a hint, but... We got it.
Oh, not that again.
What happened to the lights? I'm terrified of the dark. I can't move. Oh God, can't breathe.
Calm down, it's all right. Probably just that stupid meter. It must have ran out of money again. It's not even that dark.
Please, you got to do something about it. I'm going to faint.
Fine, just stay in my bedroom. There'll still be plenty of sunlight there at this time of the day. I'll go outside and put some money on the meter. It'll only take a minute.
She was definitely not being serious, right? Use that laptop.
Right. Let's do it.
Was that you, Mrs. Ashworth? What happened?
No idea. Maybe it's a blackout, like in the old days.
It's probably just the meter. Let me see.
Hello, we are, Geth.
So it's not her either.
Told you that.
What a waste of time. It's time to leave. This interview is over.
I don't get it. The cable's been cut. But why would anyone do that?
I think we're going to go now. This whole power cut gave me a terrible headache.
Is that you, Mitzi?
Yes.
But we haven't finished yet. Have you changed your mind about the job?
No, of course not. I'm just scared of darkness. And I still feel sick, you know. Perhaps we can continue some other time.
I'm getting a new fuse box.
Was that you, Jesse?
Yeah. How are you doing, Pauline?
Well, we need the power back. Can you do something?
Yeah, I can easily fix that. There's an electrical store that's open till late. I'll get some stuff.
Aha!
Before you know it.
Bear in mind, it's not just the fuse box. It's the cable this time.
I'll get a new cable too. Don't worry. But in the meantime, go home. Find some candles and chill, yeah?
Thanks.
Find some candles and chill, yeah?
Well, it was great seeing you, but we're going to leave now.
Who's the lady?
Hello.
Oh, there you go.
Who's that?
My name is Rita Tickle.
Rita who? What the hell is going on here?
What?
Do you know this woman, Mrs. Ashworth?
I've never seen her before in all my life.
God damn it, that fucking weird lady.
Now she'll think we are absolutely crazy.
I wouldn't worry too much. You're not exactly the most popular neighbor in the house anyway.
Well, thanks. I mean...
Thanks?
Yeah.
What? You don't actually care what those idiots think, do you?
No. Of course not.
Doesn't care what anybody thinks!
It's just that Pauline seems all right. I'm not too proud of causing her all this trouble.
It'll get fixed soon. Look, Jesse's gone out. We can now get inside flat 7
yes.
and see what he's been up to.
Yes, we can.
Okay. Yeah.
Let's do it.
That sounds
but
good.
But we should mark off that she's...
We can
she's...
also cross Pauline yeah. off the list.
Yeah.
I've searched through her internet history. And needless to say, there's nothing exciting there.
Not even porn! Okay. We'll get the last stuff that we need for the dress, I'm sure, in flat 7. Then we'll deal with Brian. Then we'll be like, nobody's the dude. And then we'll be like, oh, there's a wall behind. Oops. Okay, fine. Wait, where's the Mitzi? Where's the Mitzi head? Oh, there it is. Find the lock first.
Now that he's gone, we can get inside?
Yes, let's do that.
I'll close my eyes and you pick that lock, Mitzi.
Okay, but no peeking.
I'd never. You've really hurt my feelings now.
Yeah. Now close them.
Can't we see her pick the lock? Maybe she's
there. The
Eye of Adam.
Jesus, are these...
Relax, Mrs. A. They're just Halloween masks.
Wait, we got a mask.
Oh, good. That's good. Because I swear, if I see another bloody head...
Oh, shit. Devil's mask? Hockey mask. Hockey mask it is. Plants. None of these look illegal. I guess he just likes plants. Fair enough. Sounds pretty big. Speaker's massive and it's connected to Jesse's computer. Whenever he plays the music, the walls must be shaking. I could hear it. Jesse's PC. Oh, right. The power. Socket. Working electrical outlet, huh? Shit. There's the outlet downstairs, and then we gotta throw it up to this floor or something? Or drop it down? One of the two?
So... Who's got windows over this side of the building?
How the fuck did she plug that
Joe
in?
Joe Davis lives down right below. I guess we could also check one flat below Joe's.
Oh, okay.
I just hope the cables.
Oh, they didn't plug it in. I thought
Let's
they.
Let's find out, shall we?
Yeah. I know. There's one in the empty room. Empty flat. That. Yeah, that's right. Oh, that's good. Bailfishception. What? They're making a prequel of the Cat Lady? That pro. I thought that they were just like skipping that step and just assuming it done it. Plug in. That's one hell of a long surge protector. Solar powered. Yeah. Paying so much attention to chat, what? Oh, and the, wait, is the prequel out, though? Nice graffiti, dude.
Right. I should be able to use that computer now. Could you give me 5 minutes, Mrs. A?
5 minutes?
Why not? I'll keep an eye on the door.
I know, she extended it more. She could have pulled on it and gotten some slack. No.
It's not him either. God damn it.
We've got mask, we've got paint. We need to damage it. We've got scissors. That should do it, right? That should do her. I think. Will you ever play Dwarf Fortress? I don't know. Oh man, double resubs. Crying Satterson, 4 months, and that thing, 17 months. Thank you guys so much for the resub. Resubs. Let's use the scissors, baby.
We need to make some adjustments.
Snip, 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 snip. Game is taking longer. I mean,
now
it's still good.
This is a dress worthy of the Cat Widow.
Why don't you admit it was too small for you?
Kappa.
Ha ha, bloody ha. Why don't you just shut up?
I Whoever threw away the burnt burger.
Whoever hadn't eaten in years. You'd struggle to get a skeleton into it. This is it. We've got all we need.
Great. Are you going to tell me about the Cat Widow now?
Yes. It's story time, Mitzi.
Oh.
The legend says there was once a bad man who hated cats. He hated his neighbors too, and his job.
What's a neighbor?
And when it rained, he'd curse and smash things. He hated his bald head and his weak, ugly body. He probably hated himself the most, although he would never admit it.
I think I see where this is going.
One day, out of pure hatred for the whole world and everything that lives, he captured a family of cats and drowned them all in the river. That day, the sun turned black and all the birds went silent as the 6 kittens struggled for life. But trapped in a strong canvas bag, they never had a chance. They all died that day. All but one.
All but one.
The mother cat, in a desperate fight to set herself free, by pure luck, clawed her way out of the bag and swam to the shore. She lost everything that day. Her beautiful children and her proud husband. Her heart crashed into pieces as she watched their limp, dead bodies stolen by the current.
This is a lovely nursery rhyme.
Running after them, she followed them for days, for as long as she could. Then, eventually, she lost sight of them. She stayed on the bank of the river for a while. The world stopped turning for her, her eyes empty and blind.
Cat grew up and became Hillary Clinton.
And then, one day, she slowly slid down the bank and into the cold, dark water. She gave in to it. She let the river take her away too, cover her mouth, her ears, her eyes. But as the water filled her lungs, and she started slipping into darkness, there was another strange feeling that burst in her mind like a ball of flames. Anger, rage even, her last craving, before she drowned, was for revenge. The blood. And so she returned, reborn and changed. A cat widow, veiled in black, mistress of the cats.
Mistress of the cats.
Her body of a young woman, but her eyes of a cat. And her face, white, rotten, face of a corpse. Those who saw it rarely lived to tell the tale. She would get her revenge on all cat killers and cat torturers. But there was someone she had to see first.
Ball
someone
man.
Special. Someone she really hated the most. As the evening came, it was strangely
like a full-on thing. All right.
Flat. As he lived alone, he usually liked to fill the silence with the sound of radio or TV shows.
This is gonna be brutal, isn't it?
That night, he switched them all off, feeling anxious and tired after work. He tried to sleep, but couldn't. And for once, there wasn't anyone there he could blame for it. As he stared through the window, he kept thinking about how much he hated that view.
Isn't that the guy?
He liked it once, a long
time ago. The dude that yelled at us?
When his wife was still there.
This is actually happening right now.
Suddenly, he heard knocking on the door. Some part of him was glad, because that meant he could take it out on whoever decided to bother him.
Greg Badabinski, thank you for the resub! Bah. Bah!
There was nobody there. He almost felt disappointed. But before he turned to walk away, he suddenly noticed something down the hall.
A dead body of a disemboweled cat hung up right here.
On a nearby wall.
Whatever.
There was a giant shadow of a cat.
That's a lame choice. That's a lame choice. Bah.
Bah, bah, loud noises, et cetera.
Thank you, Bah, for that donation.
He stopped again. He couldn't believe his eyes.
Someone wrote asshole on his door.
Someone wrote cat killer on his door.
E.T. Cetera.
He had a passion for trains. Although he hated being a train driver, he had always enjoyed watching them move. But now, his train model was moving all on its own. He was absolutely certain he'd left it switched off. And yet, there it was, running at crazy speed. Remote control missing. Something was seriously wrong. And that something had entered his home now, too.
They're right here, behind him. Oh, I can't mouse. Can't see the mouse. I can't see the mouse either. Never mind.
He hoped he was just imagining things, tired as he was. But there was another surprise waiting for him in his bedroom.
A sexy cat lady. A giant blood-soaked zombie cat sat on his bed. I feel like it should say Cat Widow is here, though, because the story needs to make clear what's
cat
happening.
Cat Widow is here, was written all over the wall.
As much as I wanted to see a giant zombie cat, I'm sorry.
Getting really scared now, he decided to call the police.
What's up, Big Daddy Wes? This game's pretty creepy at times.
His phone was of no use. The SIM card had been removed, and that wasn't even the worst part. There was a photo of a black cat set as screensaver. He remembered this cat. He'd watched that strange pest control man put it in a cage and into his van. He'd looked at it through the window for a while, then pulled the curtains and went to bed.
Oh, there you
go. As in a dream, he went to the kitchen to get a drink.
Oh shit, blood.
There was no water. He knew there were valves in the basement that turn it off, but no one's been down there for years.
That's where we are right now.
He felt sick. None of this made any sense.
Oh shit, do we have
And yet, deep down, he knew what he did to the cats was wrong. There was a part of him that almost wanted to be punished. The part he tried so hard to hide.
I wonder if I have to recreate all of these things.
In the corridor. Was there someone there with him?
Uh-oh.
His head was spinning. He felt ambushed, trapped, like an animal.
Like a
he
cat.
He had to get out of there.
But he still
he
didn't
stopped,
leave.
Paralyzed. He'd heard something right in front of him.
A it says behind on screen.
More like a her. She was there, in the dark corner of his living room. Waiting. Black veil covering that pale, dead face. And yet, he could almost feel Cat Widow's eyes piercing through him. She came closer, like a ghost, and swiftly removed the veil. She came back for him, to take him to the river, to make him pay for what he'd done. As he looked into her eyes, he could feel the world spinning around him, his knees go weak, his pants suddenly wet around his crotch.
Everybody pees himself.
As much as he hated life, he didn't want to die either.
Wait.
Inside, he was just a big, stinking coward.
Then a different game.
And then he fainted.
That was something else where people were peeing themselves. He fainted!
Did you see his face? I knew he'd fall for this.
Yeah, we scared the living shit out
okay,
of him.
Okay, that's what I figured we were
now
doing
that's
it right
teamwork. Then. Are you sure he won't know it was you, though?
Oh, he probably will, once he's had time to think about what happened. But he's too proud to ever admit he's been beaten by a woman. I know him just about enough to know that.
That wasn't
Let's hope so. I don't want you to get in trouble because of me.
No. That was something I had to do for myself. And I feel much better for it.
The only problem now is that we still haven't found Eye of Adam. Because it definitely isn't Brian. I've searched through his laptop and all I found was a load of porn.
Let's cross him off the list.
All right then.
Well, that means we've checked everyone. We've hit a brick wall. Perhaps I was wrong.
The wall behind you.
Maybe he doesn't live here at all.
I think we need to sleep on it. And we might get some more ideas in the morning. Shall we head back home?
Yeah, I do feel tired. You're right, we need some sleep. Really wish there was an elevator in this building. What's that? A note? What does it say, Mrs. A?
You will not believe it. Meet me at midnight, both of you. I will wait. Flat 5. Door will be open. do not fear.
It was flat five.
Eye of Adam.
Woo!
Flat five. That's the old guy. Can't be. It can't be him.
Probably not him, but...
I guess we'll find out. At midnight. We've got a few hours until then. Let's get some coffee.
Just leave the note there. Call me a dog killer? Next time on Dragon Ball Z. Oh, here we go. Wait, what? No, never mind. Yes! Yes! Called it! Other side of the wall, right?
It's just you and me, my love. No one will find us here. Stop worrying, Ivy. It will be all right. I will always love you. You know that. I'm gonna make you all better.
Good thing she didn't scream while we were right next to that wall. Chapter 6 complete. This is the final chapter. Chapter 7 right here. Oh, she gained some weight. Hello, daughter. She's just gonna start remembering all the creepy things. Those cats aren't black. This game is something else.
Tell you what.
Well? Hi, beautiful bear in a tutu. Welcome. I can't do anything right now. Wait, can I? Oh, I can do things. I didn't want to, Okay, good. I didn't want to, like, interrupt this. Oh, I can also move. So what I need to do is I need to go heat up some pizza real quick. Like, 2 minutes in the microwave. Then I'll come back. And then we'll truck on with Chapter 7. Because I'm hungry. Definitely hungry. But don't worry. It won't be long. And then we'll continue with this. Cliffhanger, almost there! Not break now. Almost. I'll leave it right here. Right here. And I'll be right back. Continue with the cat lady. All right. Back. I'm back. We're here. Let's find out what's awaiting us in Flat 5. Flat 5! I'm like, look at that water. There isn't...
Just look at this door.
Seems normal.
Crazy son of a bitch. That's not gonna stop us. I think there's someone in the kitchen.
They do, Norian.
Are you Adam?
Me? No, of course not. I don't have anything to do with all this foolishness. Never have. It's my son. I've told him time and time again, but he never listens. I've done my best to protect that boy, you know. I'm all he's got left in the world since his mama died, but...
Mama!
Just wasn't enough.
Where is he, then? Where's Eye of Adam?
He's in his room. Where else would he be? He's always in his room, staring at that screen for as long as he can. Look, I've made up my mind about this.
No! Sorry. Lobot crashed. I don't know why he crashed. That doesn't seem...
Want to help.
Anyways.
This mess he's in. It's gone too far. I can't be part of this.
What are you talking about?
You don't understand. He's watching us. Right now, he can see us on his camera. He's very clever with this stuff. I never got my head around it. Just as much as I needed to, I guess. But not a lot.
Give us the key to his room. I want to talk to him.
Look, it's a trap. He knows why you're here, and he will kill you. Both of you. But he will not kill me. He won't dare. All these years... I've looked after him well. He owes me everything. It breaks my heart to do this now. What choice do I have? He left me this. I was supposed to keep it for myself. But I want you to take it. He won't dare to kill his own father. And I won't let two innocent lives be lost because of him.
What is it?
Just take the damn thing. There's not much time.
An old man
mask.
Hear
me? He's watching.
Uh-oh. Oh my god. Ryko! Thank you for subscribing! Welcome to the Wolf Pack. This is a trap right here. This is a trap about to happen right here. Thank you for the sub.
What is it, Mrs. A?
It's a shoebox.
Take it away! Get rid of it! He must see that I don't have it anymore!
Shall we open it?
Death mask.
Oh god. Mitzi, we have to get out of here. Quickly.
What's in the box? Mask.
He's going to poison us.
Nice Christmas lights, though. Oh! Uh-oh. Well.
It's too late!
Shit. Oh. Shit. Shit. Shit.
No! No! Stop that, Adam! You're going to kill your father!
We'll never make it to the door. That room is filling up with gas too quickly. Put the mask on, Mrs. A.
What about you? No, no, I can't.
No, give it
You've
to Mitzi.
Got to. This is your
I'm
only
immortal.
Chance.
No, I can't let you die.
I'm immortal,
not
you
like
idiot.
This.
It's my fault that you're
you stupid
here.
Idiot,
you're dying
stupid.
Anyway. And you.
And I'll
you've
never
got to live,
die.
Mrs. A. If... You'll live and you'll be happy again.
No, I won't.
You've been a great friend, Mrs. A.
God damn it. Give the mask to Mitzi, you stupid idiot.
You've got a date, and I'll make sure you turn up for it.
I can't.
There is no time to argue. I'll be fine. Now. Do it!
Wait, achievement unlocked sacrifice? What?
Mitzi.
Nobody cares about the old man. Is he dancing? Well, now I just wake up in hell, right? Or whatever. Uh-oh. Go left. Nope. I got an achievement for doing that, so that almost seems kind of final. Maybe.
Welcome home, darling. I've been waiting for you. What took you so long?
Say what you've got to say and let's finish this. I'm tired of you. Tired of all this madness. I just need to get back.
Very well. I'm not planning to keep you long. Let's go inside. I have one last job for you.
Hold on, did we?
There are still two candles left, Susan. You know how this works. A soul for a soul.
And that's it. I blow out the last candle, and I'll never have to see you again.
Only if you blow out the
oh,
right
no.
One. I'll never bother you again. Isn't that what you want? But if you choose wrong, it will be your life extinguished forever.
Wait, isn't that what I want?
Just take a deep breath and do it.
What?
But how should I know which one's right?
That's the thing, Susan. You can't know that. In life, you can't always know the consequences before you make a decision. Haven't you learned that yet?
That's not fair.
Nothing is fair. You opened your heart talking to that doctor, and he butchered you like an animal. Then, those disgusting cannibals, they chop you up and cook you for dinner if you'd let them. And what about the man with the flowers? All that he wanted was to hear you play before he split your skull open. The way your husband treated you, the way your neighbors laughed at you for years, just for being different. You did not deserve all that, and yet it happened. Am I forgetting something? Oh, yes, of course. Most of all, was it fair that...
Shut up! Just shut up, you ugly bitch! Now I know who you really are.
Blah.
All those feelings I had in me for years. That bitter guilt and self-pity. That hatred for myself and everyone else.
You're me!
You are that miserable illness that's consumed my heart all these years. You, always there, always. Every day I looked at you in the mirror, like a dark cloud I couldn't see through. I let you take control of my life. I believed it was right to feel like this.
but not any longer. This ends here.
Then blow out the candle.
Blow them both out. Yeah, if I have to blow out the correct candle. If I blow out both of them, that means that I blow both correct candles. Can I save here? No, I can't save right now. I have no. Evidence for either candle, so I'm gonna refuse. Let's just see what it's like.
No, I won't. I'm done playing your stupid little games. You won't tell me what to do anymore. I am stronger than you. I can close my eyes and you'll be gone.
Blow out the candle.
It's time to say goodbye, sister. I'm not gonna miss you.
You will never leave this place without me. You need me. We are one.
No. Tomato.
Tomato.
You were thinking about a tomato, right?
What the fuck is a tomato? Where are we?
Tomato is a fruit, silly.
Who cares? I like tomatoes.
So do I. But I hate to disappoint you, but I was really thinking of onions.
Why onions?
They're the saddest of the vegetables, of course. They make people cry. What happened, Mrs. A?
Call the whole thing off.
And yet, you're here. Alive, like if nothing's ever happened.
Well, let's put it this way. What? Everyone knows cats have 9 lives. So do cat ladies, apparently. But this time, I feel there won't be second chances. I'm down to 1 last life now. I can't afford to waste it.
You are such a nutter, Mrs. A.
Nutter.
Absolutely fucking bonkers. But I'm so happy to see you. Never, ever do that to me again, all right?
I can happily promise you that, Mitzi.
This is it. His room is through that door.
Oh.
It's time to face the Eye of Adam.
What are we waiting for? Let's
gotcha.
Do it.
Gotcha. Well. Huh. I wonder if, like, left candle, like, could have been Mitzi, and right candle could have been, like, Eye of Adam or something. I don't know. Say hi. Oh. Oh. The fuck?
You're the Eye of Adam?
What a scrub.
A pathetic wheelchair-bound invalid? Is this a joke? Do you know who I am? Do you know what you've done to me? You fucking murderer! Tonight it's your turn to die. I'm gonna paint this room with your brains and I'm gonna watch and smile. I swear to God I'll do it. Well, nothing to say? Nothing at all? Aren't you going to beg for your sad little life? Say something! Anything!
Lol.
Mitzi, Where did you get that gun from?
It doesn't matter. Please, Mrs. A. This is something I have to do. You're free to leave if you want. You don't have to be a part of it. Just try to understand. Beg for forgiveness, you scum! What the fuck is wrong with you? You don't believe I'm gonna shoot you, do you? Oh, I've dreamt of this moment for so long.
Look at this man, Mitzi. He hasn't twitched a muscle since we entered the room. I think he's paralyzed.
That's impossible. He's lying to us. He's faking it. Do something. Talk for God's sake. I need you to answer me. I need to know.
He won't answer you. He can't talk.
Then how did he post all that stuff online? What the?
Talk through the screen. Yeah, there you go. There you go. There you go. Did it say hi? Hi. Oh. What? Okay.
How did he do it?
I think I know how.
With his dick!
See that little device on his left eye? I've heard about these. It's a controller. It seems the only part of his body he can move is his eyeball. Controller connected to the computer tracks its movement, allowing him to...
What?
Eye of Adam!
That's ridiculous! How do you even know such things?
I'm a nurse? I've seen these before.
Sin?
Well, I've seen eye-controlled wheelchairs, but there's no reason why it wouldn't work with a computer.
Jesus. That would explain the whole Eye of Adam thing. He really is just the eye. But no, that doesn't change anything. He must die. He deserves nothing more.
If you kill me, it only makes me stronger. Do it, Figgit!
You arrogant shit! I will fucking do it! Just tell me one thing. One thing. Why? Why did you make Jack kill himself?
For the lulz. Uh-oh.
Fine. It'll be a pleasure. Ready to die, scumbag?
Look at these oxygen tanks. I don't think it's a good idea.
What? Why not? I'm the one holding a gun here. And I will blow this bastard's brain out as soon as he looks at me. You hear me?
Flammable.
Look at me. I want you to see what you've done. The pain you've caused me.
Mitzi, that's not what I meant. Just put the gun down for a second.
No. No. I can't do that, Mrs. A. I'm sorry. This is something I have to do. I have to.
Can't you hear that hissing sound? These cylinders are clearly leaking gas.
Please, stay out of it!
You'll make a whole room blow up.
A whole room?
I don't care. Just leave me alone.
Wouldn't it be much more satisfying to, like, punch the shit out of him over and over until he died instead? And bypass the fact that you're gonna explode the room?
You lied to me. You never said you wanted to kill him.
Now. Wasn't that quite obvious? What did you think I wanted to do? Have a coffee with him? Chat about the weather or politics? For God's sake, I'm here because this son of a bitch needs to die. If I don't kill him now, You'll just carry on and more innocent people will lose their lives.
A lot of the voiceover in this...
Do you really want that?
...is because very I clippy. Don't. Oh, whoops.
Think about it for a second. Would Jack really want this?
This bastard messed with Jack's head. He tricked him. That's what he does. He fucking tricked him.
But would Jack really want you to become a murderer?
No. He wouldn't. He wasn't violent at all. He was the kindest, sweetest guy I ever knew.
Exactly. Now, put that gun down already.
But what about me? No, I'll do it. I know Jack will forgive me.
This isn't the way to do it. Just turn these computers off instead.
No! He doesn't deserve to live after what he's done.
And who are you to serve justice like this? Do you really want to kill an unarmed, paralyzed
man? Take a dump in his lap.
Why are you doing this, Mrs. A? I thought you were my friend.
That's exactly why I'm doing this. Even if we survive the explosion, how will you be able to live with yourself?
I won't have very long to live with it. I'll manage just fine.
Without his father, he's harmless.
Without his father, he's harmless. He was the one who supplied him with all this technology. He fulfilled his every single wish. I know this guy's rotten bad. There's no excuse for what he did. But he will be punished for it. Trust me. They'll put him in some stinking nursing home. He'll live his life like a vegetable. Stuck to bed, he'll have time to think about what he's done. And he'll never see a computer screen again. Isn't that enough?
He said, do it! He wants to die, and I want to kill him.
He wants us all to die. Can't you see that? Isn't that what he's been preaching? A joint suicide. That's why he wants you to shoot him. So we can all get blown to pieces.
His final act. The work of his life. Are you really going to give him that satisfaction? Remember what you said about feeding the troll? That's exactly what you're going to do if you kill him.
Don't
now.
Feed the troll!
No. Maybe you're right. You should leave, Mrs. A. I'd never want you to get hurt. But I'm not going away without this fucker dead. Even if that means I die too.
Mitzi, have you lost your mind? You're going to sacrifice your life for this scum? He's a parasite! A worthless, evil piece of shit!
It's not like I've got anyone to live for, is
it? Pick up an O2 canister.
What?
What about me?
What about your mother? Your family.
She's dead.
Smash this dude with an O2 canister.
I always lie. I grew up in an orphanage. My family never wanted to know me. The only person that cared about me was Jack. And he's dead. Yeah. Happy now? So get the fuck out of here and let me do what I got to do.
Grimeyer hype.
I care about you. Do it for me.
That's right. Music stopped and everything. Achievement unlocked! I care about you!
Come on, mate. It's been a long day. Let's go home. We've won.
Like, bash him in the face with the
Have we really?
Gun.
Trust me. I know we have.
Get good, Scrub.
I'm the cat lady. From now on, I win every single
day. Oh, shit! That son of a bitch. Is he gonna type shit? Just type shit, you nerd. Nope.
It's me, again, talking about my ordinary little life, as usual. I'm still surprised anyone would want to read this at all. The ramblings of a cat lady. Maybe I'm not a cat lady anymore. Things have changed here since Mitzi's death.
No! Oh, right. Cancer.
I'll never forget those last few weeks. It's a horrible way to die. Stuck in a hospital bed with no hope and whole life to pass you by. 6 months ago, I lost the best friend I'd ever had. But at least we knew it was coming. I had time to accept it, just like she did. And I can only be glad we spent that time together. I still miss her, though. Every day. Did I ever mention I got into all this because of her?
Into all this? Game development?
I opened her laptop the night after the funeral.
Oh.
And there it was. A friend request.
Social media.
Over a year old. A little gift from behind the grave. I met some people. We go out sometimes. And I'm not alone anymore. It turned out there were others who felt like I did. I talked to them. Tried to help.
Yeah, what about the giant fucking bloody demon thing in the basement with the Hello?
And now I'm writing this blog.
Oh my god, a blogger.
I must confess, yesterday was bad.
Bed.
It was one of those days when you feel like you're back in the past and all the good stuff that happened was just a dream.
Another game? A positive image in this game?
But I woke up today feeling better. Maybe I can never get rid of it. This
I cannot mute
invisible
it. I know.
Illness. Maybe it will always be living somewhere deep inside me. Asleep. Waiting. And when it'll hit me, it'll hit me hard.
Glasses fit beautifully on this. Wonderful.
But if there's one thing Mitzi taught me, it's that you have to pick yourself up and carry on. It doesn't matter that life isn't fair. It doesn't matter that you make mistakes. You fall and rise again. World's full of liars, traitors, cowards. But every now and then, you meet someone like Mitzi, who will just smile at it all. Now, I've forgiven the world and myself too. I teach myself to smile again. One day I'll get there. I know I will. Even if it takes me not 9, but 900 lives.
900 lives? Cat lady complete. You are my star, glowing bright in endless charm, growing stronger day by day. Forever.
Well. Cool. It seems like there was multiple things to happen in that last section. I was going to be like, oh, let's just restart and check the other way. But I feel like it could branch potentially several ways. I'd be curious to at least look it up on YouTube. But, but yeah, cool. Very, very emotional game. But, you know, I enjoyed it. It was a cool experience, I think. SOTC is Shadow of the Colossus. And we are going to, looks like, look it up collectively on stream. Until Dawn is actually going to start next Monday. Well, Monday. So in 3 days. Best ending, you cure cancer. Wow, impressive. Press any key to live. Ah, I just closed the game. That's funny. Oh, I gotta go live, guys. Sorry. I'll see you later. Bye.